What you're about to see is the long-lost pilot episode of the Pixel Art Show. It was thought to be destroyed in the great hard drive crash of 2014 and hasn't been seen since. Until now. One pixel is the smallest controllable element of an image. We see billions of them every day, but this was not always the case. In the adolescence of the digital age, every pixel was precious. A single dot could be the eye of a space invader or the bouncing ball in Breakout. Each pixel was a necessary contribution to the mosaic of the screen. As our technology has grown, so has the desire for better graphics with improved resolution. It seems the individual pixel has been all but forgotten. Still, there are those of us who remember the power of the pixel and are using a classic medium to bring them back to life, not digitally, but here in the real world. Yes, it's that most colorful and creative craft,
Perler beads! That's right, these little melty pieces of plastic are back! And it turns out, people are using them to create some pretty cool pixel art pieces. Today, I'm going to show you the simple step-by-step process on how to make your own artwork with the help of one of my favorite cartoon characters. Join me in our studio of imagination. Today we're going to be making an Inspector Gadget piece on a 16 by 20 inch canvas with multiple levels. That will provide a neat 3D effect, and it also makes it a heck of a lot easier to iron because we can iron one piece at a time and then put it together later, as opposed to ironing one huge thing. As you can see, I've sketched out our plan here. We'll have the Inspector in the center foreground with the robotic arms rising out of the back, topped off with the gadget hands. Level-wise, this means that arms will be attached to the canvas, with the Inspector and his gadgets on the level above that. These are all pieces of a puzzle that we'll have to put back together at the very end, so it's important to know what pieces go on which level. But now that we have our plan, let's roll up our sleeves and let the beads fly. Now that our subject is beaded, it's time for the most important step, ironing. Depending on the kind of ironing job you do is going to determine what your piece looks like at the very end, because the heat from this iron is going to cause your beads to melt or fuse into each other. There are many methods and techniques when it comes to ironing, but for now, we're just going to cover the basics.
Gently place the ironing paper on top of your work. Start slowly ironing one side and work your way across in a circular motion. You'll be able to see the beads melting through the paper, so keep an eye on them to make sure you're ironing evenly. Then flip it over and do the other side.
All right, here's the Inspector, and he's looking good! Now obviously I've sped up parts of my video for the sake of time, but you want to make sure you give your pieces plenty of time to cool before handling them. I also recommend putting some big heavy books on top to help keep them flat. I recommend the complete works of William Shakespeare. To bead or not to bead? I'm gonna go with two bead because we still have to make the gadget hands.
Thank you.
While we're waiting for those to cool, let's go paint our canvas.
We've got our canvas. We've got our pieces. Now let's use our trusty hot glue gun to put it all together.
Things beads are. There's something immensely satisfying about creating a solid work of art like this. The time and care that go into it are obvious. And yet, it's not as fragile as a drawing or a painting. No, this is hands-on. This can be touched. In fact, pearler beads are so sturdy that they can be used to create jewelry, coasters, and magnets. There is no limit to what you can imagine, and we have much to discuss on this incredibly creative craft. Until next time, happy pearling!